Morning, guys. I have a parcel. I was hoping I got enough power in the battery to do this. So, as it's quite a large parcel, oh, it's going to be too high for you, isn't it? What about there? Close enough. Shall we open it? I think we all know what it is. Did I even get that in the right place? Close enough. Another one. It's a decent box. But I don't want the box. Right. Oh, well, I didn't know that. I did not know that. I've got the key with this one as well. Taped to the bottom, we have the key. I've lost count on how many of them keys I have now. Just trying to see where the tape started. Here we go. Just tear into it like an animal, shall we? Yeah. In reasonably good condition. Got some chips around the edge here. But these ones always did that. In theory, oh good, it was in the on position. I'll leave that in the on position. My battery is beside you guys. Don't come on yet. On position, it is in the on position. It's another flash one, not the static one. I don't matter. I will just double check that I did actually click on the right one. There's three lamps ending today from another seller. One of those is actually tempting. Description. Whoops. That was my bad. Oh, and the battery's gonna die. Hang on. Okay, I've got the external power supply plugged in. I was actually playing with the electric bike this morning, and I got some sort of life out of it. I twisted the throttle, speed control, whatever you want to call it, all the way back, then turned the key, and I got what looks like an error code flash. The LED sort of scanned left and right a few times, a bit like the Knight Rider car, and then the middle LED just flashed on and off, and that's all it did. So I'm thinking that it might be telling me the battery pack's got a fault, which could mean that that battery that didn't take charge, well, it did, but I tested it again this morning, and despite the charger being connected and on all night, it actually dropped down to 6 volts. So it's actually dropping voltage, not charging. Which could indicate a faulty battery. I'm going to try it on another charger. But what I'm going to do, just to test the theory, I've got another little 12 volt battery. Actually, I've got a few little 12 volt batteries. I'm going to jury-rig a test cable from the battery, so I haven't got to put it all together, from the battery pack to the bike, and see if I can get any life out of it that way. If I get life out of it with a different 12 volt battery, then I will know that the issue is one of the batteries. Which means if I sold it, I would have to sell it for less, because it would have to go as spares or repairs. I don't know if Catch Custom Trike still wants it, actually. I'll have to remember to ask her. She hadn't said anything for a while, but she did. At one point she was saying she was determined to get it off of me, but I wouldn't let it go with the battery pack, because if it is a faulty battery, all three would need replacing anyway, so there's no point including it. I could include the case, but not the batteries. Simply because they are old, they are from 2003, so I'm actually surprised two of them are still holding a steady 12.5 volts. I'm surprised they haven't done what the third one has done, if it's the battery. I'm going to try a different charger for a little while and see if I can breathe some life into it. I've got no freaking idea where I'm going to set it up. Somewhere in the bedroom, I expect, out of the way. Anywho, what I'm going to do, I don't actually know if I'm going to see Mum after 2 o'clock when she's finished her shift. She said she might try and pop up. But what I'm going to do in the meantime is have a quick clean up in this lounge. I've got some bags and crap and rubbish everywhere. Just give me a bit more room. I'm going to move this black printer into the bedroom for now. Along with the battery charger on it, because that's the one I'm going to use. Old Faithful, that's the one I'm going to use. Check the charge on the 12 volt battery on the shelf here. Oh, pardon me. It's just over there behind the Lego building. That's the closest I've got. Turn the screen the wrong way. And then later on, probably once Mother has been, if she turns up, well, that says a big if, she doesn't know. I suppose it depends how knackered she is. I'm going to be doing some building work on a Lego house over there. Modifying an old model, actually, and extending or building onto it. Renovating, we'll call it renovating. Yeah. I'm not really bothered that I accidentally purchased the wrong lamp. Because I like these lamps anyway. So, I've got £7 in my bank. I'm a pound short from buying another one. But I can't just go and put a pound in the bank. I think the minimum is a £5 note. I don't have one. I've only got a £10 note. So I'm going to leave it till Monday anyway. If they sell, they sell. If they don't, they don't. Anyway, I'm going to go and get some things done. And I'll talk to you all when I have some news on that electric bike. Hopefully some better news. Well, I thought I'd show you what this thing is doing. Well, as we know, when I do that, absolutely nothing. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this. This is going to be awkward because I need three hands. One to hold the camera. Well, actually, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll get it to start. That's what it does when I hold that back, just to prove. See, it scrolls like that a few times, and then it's just that LED that flashes on and off. See, when I do that, there's nothing. That's got me puzzled. I don't know. I couldn't find anything about error codes on the internet, so I got that charging. I'm actually just going to take a clip off and yeah, it's definitely juiced up. That's actually gone down to about 5 point something volts, so here we go. What are we up to? Oh, that charged pretty quick. We're up to 11.7 volts already. It's only been on for an hour or so. Couple of hours, so that's how fast. Whee, sparks. That's how fast it's meant to charge. That's the one I'm going to sort of temporarily bodge in. And just to see if it is that one battery that's causing the issue. We'll find out soon enough. I expect it's been on that charge for a few hours, actually. I'll give it till about 4 o'clock, so about another hour, hour and a half, something like that. And about an hour and a quarter. And I'll check that battery again, and if it's charged, I'll see if I can find a bit of cable, 2-cord cable, in my pot over there, and we'll see which is which. That box isn't actually screwed together, but at least I know the battery contacts are making contact in there, so I know it's not a contact issue. What I want to do is figure out which end the power is taken from, or even just try to screw a couple of wires on this on that side, just a temporary. I'll find some way of temporarily rigging it. Could come with a live off of the fuse, actually. That might be an idea. Or unscrew the wires from that and just twist a couple of wires around it for now, and then I was just going to touch the wires on the two contacts there and turn the key. But it's that end battery that's failed, as far as I can tell. Like I said, I'm going to take it out when this battery is charged and see if that charger can breathe life into it, because that's the one that I charged before. Used to charge it before. So, for all I know, the other charger, well, the charger was putting out the same sort of voltage, 11 point something volts. Which I suppose is not a bad thing, because it means 12 volt batteries aren't getting overvolted at least, are they? Which could prove to be dangerous if you did that. I've been working on a house, that's all I've been doing pretty much. Listening to the radio, drinking, and just passing time really while I wait for that to charge. But, this was my sort of bedsit house I built, you know, it had the bedroom up the corner, kitchen, lounge area. Well, I'm now converting it into a house. It was sold and it's being redeveloped. I've extended the kitchen. I've got a weird imagination. You've got to have an imagination though when you're doing things like this. Fully equipped kitchen. That's the only room that's got furniture in at the minute. All the shutters are closed on the windows. What did I do with that tray? Here it is. I've got some profile bricks in here. I may stick these under the window. Have I got enough? Because I would actually have to do upstairs and downstairs. There's another two. 2, 4, 6, 8. And I need 10 for the downstairs. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And I've got enough for one upstairs window. I'm sure I had some more of those somewhere. What did I do with them? Did I throw them up here? I may have got tossed in up here with this lot when I was sorting my Lego out. I can't see them up here now though. My mock fire engine. I can't remember why that's not in the fire station. I think it's a bit too tall with that ladder on it. Yeah, if I had some more of those. I could do brown. No little wood effect under there. That'll add a bit of, yeah. Shitloads of brown, so I'll try that and see what it looks like. If not, I've got a few more tan up here I can use. Enough on there to do another three windows. So if I had four windows upstairs, I would actually have enough tan. I think what I'll do one window with brown, one window with the tan, and see which one I like best. Yeah, that's my plan for the afternoon then. I'll zip across to Lidl's at some point for another couple of bottles of cola and something for dinner. Oh. A bar of chocolate there, I've opened it up, now I don't want it. Not really. Well. I'll have a bite. Right. I've got a skedaddle. Kill some more time while I wait for the battery to charge. At the rate that's charged, I should think that would probably take about another hour. 2 hours tops, maybe, to bring that up to... I'll bring it up to 12.5 volts. That should be enough, and that'll match pretty much the other two, so... Yeah. Right. I'll talk to you later. When the battery's charged, because we'll play with that together. Good news. The battery I charged works on the bike. I've sort of jury-rigged it up to the other batteries and ran a cable, actually secured it to the battery contacts on the casing itself. Just undone the screws, wrapped the wire around it, done the screws back up, and touched it onto the contacts on the bike, and I got all LEDs lit up straight away. So the problem is the battery, which is on charge over here. Now, I actually do think it's fucked because it doesn't even spark. All the other batteries I've had on charge have sparked, and I forgot I had that one. I could have, instead of charging up that battery, I could have just used that one. I forgot that was in the kitchen. There's still enough charge in it. I don't know why those green LEDs are on. I've disconnected it now, but that's good. That means that nothing there is broken. I mean, I could still sell it. Spares, repairs. Or keep it. Well, yeah, it's gonna need probably, you're probably better off putting a full set. I mean, these ones are still good. They're still working and holding charge. Yeah, that's what I connected the wires onto. That thing there. Being careful not to clunk the wires together because you get some very good sparks at 36 volts. I did try it. I thought it was going to weld the wires together. Should have had the camera on, really. See, I can't. I've got nothing to hold you with to demonstrate. That's why I didn't put the camera on, but yeah, it does work. I could easily stick this back together. Quite easily, actually. That battery's still warm. I could rig this sort of battery into it for the time being, but it'll go flat before the other two because they're not the same rate. Hang on a minute. The bloody went on there a little while ago. Ah, there we go. See if we can have a bit of fun, shall we? See if I can get them twisted together. And that's stuffed into the end of this. Enough just to get contact. And, shall we? Yeah. Ooh, pah. That's a smelling. Phew, that smells like burnt hair. Well, that's proof my battery pack is charged anyway, isn't it? I'm seeing. Don't know if it's going to show there. Turn the switch on. Sort of see something flashing at the bottom of the screen. Here, hang on, can I just do that? There we go, I've got all lights now. So, yeah, that's definitely the issue. I've got a faulty battery. So I've got a choice. I could either go buy one for 20 quid, buy all three for 120 quid, get rid of it, spares and or repairs, and keep them two batteries. There's no point, like I said, there's no point me getting rid of it with the batteries, because these might be holding charge now, but for how long? Considering they're well over 10 years old, they could give out at any time. I don't actually know if there is a life expectancy on these lead acid batteries, but I think they've done well for 10 years. So I'm going to leave this one on charge for an hour. So it read 5.5 volts when I looked at it. I mean, it was taking charge, and all of a sudden it stopped with the other one, but we'll see. We have got... Wee! I shouldn't do that because I'll probably trip something out, but I do that just to make sure the charger itself is working. That's what I spent most of the day doing to kill time. Built a nice little house. It faces the ocean, if you're wondering why the end of the driveway is there and there's no gate here. Side entrance. I ran out of brick for the roof. I've got 3 rows to do, so I'm going to have to go shopping for some brick. And, nice little balcony. Right. Well, I'm off to Mum's tomorrow. She did turn up. I thought I was zoomed in a little bit. Well, that's good. At least I know the actual main computer part of the bike isn't knackered. That's the bit that worried me, because if that had died and I couldn't get replacement parts of whatever died on it, then yeah. That would have pretty much made that a write-off. Still not sure what I want to do with it. One battery causing all this bloody problem. Just bring up eBay. I'm actually watching some lamps on eBay and I don't know whether to buy them or not. If I do, it's going to put me really short till the next time I get paid. Unless there's any bikes at the dump tomorrow. If there's bikes at the recycle centre tomorrow, then it's not going to be a problem, but it's such a gamble because I don't know what's up there. I could, you know, get Mum to ask Biggles, but I mean, there's two here. He's got 3 that I'm interested in. Actually, this seller, Betty Swallocks, is the seller's name. Yeah, it's they've swapped the letters around, so instead of saying Sweaty Bollocks, it says Betty Swallocks. This seller is actually very close to me, so I could. Although I think I've asked before, if memory serves correct, I could have gone up there to collect it, but I don't think they do that. But yeah, there's this one, which is a steady burn version with a photo cell. There's the metal version of what I've got. Well, actually, my plastic version of this has got the little hanging loop at the top there as well. This is $9.99. Nobbids. This one he's selling quite cheap. $3.99 start bid, no bids. And then he's got that very rare red one. $17.99, no bids. But I'm actually wondering if I should just go for the two cheapest, because there's going to be like... a little less than 20 quid. So I could easily pay for that Monday.
So I don't think anyone's going to bid on it, so I could always watch it again and try the second time round. Yeah, I could do that, just go for the two cheapest ones, because he's actually got it listed as rare, but I've seen another listing on here. Actually, I couldn't find it. No, that's because I didn't look under that search title. But there is someone selling these as skip lights. And go on the edge of dumps, on the end, yeah, on the sides of dumpsters, skips, whatever, mobile dumpster, whatever you want to call it. They get delivered by a lorry and then picked up when they're full. You know, you can hire them. Builders hire them, people can hire them if they've got a crap load of stuff to get rid of.
Duh.
But it's only for when they're sitting on the side of a road, so, you know, there's the warning there of a hazard. But anyway, this seller is selling, I don't actually know how many he's got. He's got two adverts up. We've got time, we'll show you. But Betty Swarks has got it listed as rare. Well, I suppose in a sense it is. You can get these, look. Little LED ones, 18 quid each. There they are. So he's got these ones and secondhand skip lamps for sale, 10 for 80 quid. That just says more than 10 available and one lot has been sold. 80 quid for 10 of those. You see, these are the JSP metal ones. These ones are that's what these are, look, X Rentals, Ashton Direct Hire. That's where my Maxilites come from. There was someone on eBay liquidating an old rental place, you know, where you can rent stuff like that from. They were liquidating their stock, and that's why I ended up with 10 Maxilites for £10. I don't know what I was thinking at the time. I don't know why I bought 10. There's some used ones. Greenham, you see. I've got a Dorman Traffy Lamp E with the Greenham sticker on. That's your distributor. There's a bracket for the, it goes around the skip to stop you nicking your lights. Brand spanking new one there. There's a Permic one. I've got a Permic. This looks different to the one I've got though. Box for 70 quid of 20 Dorman lamps. Cone lights, I've got enough of those. Synchro guide for 20 quid. If I had two or three of those, they would all flash in sequence because I've got a little sensor right there from the look of it. Yeah, expensive ones. Oh, this one's labelled Silverline. It's a rip-off of the Dorman Unilamp. Any more? Some CDs. Is that it on here? I think that's it. I think the rest is just other stuff. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for them too. Why not? It's my fucking money. If I do end up putting myself short, then whose fault is it? Mine. I don't even go asking to borrow money from people. I just deal with it because it's my problem. I've always been like that. I could borrow. Well, I know Mum will always get me a few bits anyway, if I need it, but I think I'm good for the moment. I'm going to add on my post. Siren's going crazy there. They've been going crazy all bloody week. Anyway, I'm going to go back to my eBay. I'm surprised no one's bid on this red one yet. I wouldn't be surprised if that does get bid on towards the end though. Well, there's 10 minutes between this one and the JSP, so I'm actually just going to watch it just to see if anyone bids on it. That's all. There's just over half an hour left. It's a nice one. Again, I don't know. You see, I could go for this one and go for the other ones later. Or even go for this one and perhaps the doorman and leave the JSP. Oh, I don't bloody know. Whatever way I do it, I'm going to be spending roughly the same amount of money. Well, unless I get this and the JSP, then I'll be spending more money, but these aren't common. I don't even know why it's got a red lens. I know the police had blue ones, and I would love to get hold of a blue one more than a red one, if I'm honest. But they really, really are hard to get hold of. All these other flashing beacons for sale. Shall I get some, one of these for Mum's car? $15.99. They've got blue silicone. This is, I've got identical ones of those. But mine's amber. Listing is for two flares. £15 something for two flares. That's actually pretty cheap with free postage. Comes three times AAA batteries not supplied. Visible by day, 300 metres distance. That's not bad. Visible by night, 900 metres on road or water. 16 kilometre visible from the air. Switch rotate quad flash. Doesn't tell you what colour the LEDs are. Bet they're fucking blue, and that's why it's not telling you. Because strictly speaking, you're not supposed to sell blue flashing lights like that, according to eBay's rules. I don't know why. He's got this one listed as one very rare flashing doorman uniflash. Right, well, I'm going to turn the camera off. Might have a nice soak in the bathtub. Leave that battery on charge for a little while and see if it will take any charge from that charge. If it doesn't, then it's fucked. So, we'll see. We'll see. I may even have a couple of road lamps. I can't pay for them till Monday because I can't get to the bank. But, yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Well, I won the auction for the JSP Metal Flash, or whatever it's called, I can't remember. The $9.99 one, not the one with the red lens, the other one I was talking about, I won that one. I decided to go for it. This one's got 11 minutes left. I do have versions of this, but I don't have the static or steady burn one or a photo cell one, so it's a dormant traffy light. I've got plenty of the traffy lamp E's, which is what those ones are. That one's got the Batchley name on it, but that's the distributor's name, not the manufacturer's. They're dormant traffy lamp E's, that's what they are. Anyway, I've got this on charge, and it's only been on charge like 40 minutes-ish, and it's already up to 6-point-something volts. So, the fact it's taking charge again, I'm going to leave this charger on here. I am going to take a bath, I'm just waiting for this auction to end. I don't mind paying $3.99 for a lamp. It's going to be just under 20, because I think this guy does combine postage as well, so I think he uses my Hermes as well, much to my delight. But payment will be sorted Monday. He does say payment to be received within 2 days. Well, can't get to a bank on a Sunday. Well, I can, but it's not going to be open be there a long time. Yeah, so I've got 9 minutes left on that one. And I'm going to jump in a bath. And my legs are going to fucking sting, because I get these, like, well, they look like and feel like bites to me. I've been scratching myself to pieces. I've got, they're now sore. Anyway, hopefully I can breathe some life into that battery and get this battery thing put back together and put back on here. Oh, I'm sorry, you don't know how glad I am to find that it isn't the computer control there, because that would have been a nightmare if that had failed. Alright, some pretty sparks in the other segment as well. Lots of pretty sparks. Yeah, I don't know why, it just seems like that one stopped charging it. Because I would have thought as well, maybe I just weren't getting a good enough connection on the cables, because I haven't got clamps on this one, I need to get some. That's probably what it was, I actually probably weren't getting a good enough connection. So one of these days I will go on eBay and get some clips for that. Out of all the battery chargers I've got, that ancient old German one down there is the only one with the clips. Clamps, whatever you want to call them, alligator clamps. But I know these can be obtained on eBay, so I'm going to need 2, 4, 6, about 4 pairs. I am going to need some slightly heavier duty ones for that one on there, because that is a, it's designed to jumpstart a car as well, that one. That's why I'm not keen on the idea of getting rid of it. But I should have, I think, 3 in here, if I remember correctly, somewhere. Yeah, there's one there. Too dark to see, but there is one under there. Then I've got these two up here. One of these I'm definitely going to keep here, because it has got the 6 volt. Yeah, it's this one. My Hilke. That's got the 6 volt, you see. No clips. These all come from the same friend as well. For some reason, none of them have got clips. No idea why. But, you know, I could sell these, but I just see no point. Because you can pick one up like this brand new cheap enough. They're cheap as chips. And then I think this one's that dinky little one. Yeah. That weird ass one. Those two are for 12 volt batteries only. That's the only new one I've got that does 12 and 6. Then I've got my old one through here that does 12 and 6. Back in the day, motorbike batteries were 6 volt. A lot of cars became 12 volt, but a lot of motorbikes and mopeds and whatnot and scooters still had 6 volt systems. I don't think it was until the 80s that they actually started with the 12 volt. I could be wrong. But nearly everything I've come across or encountered that's from the 70s has always been 6 volt. But if anyone knows any different, please let me know. I'm always open to learning, you know. If I've got a fact wrong, let me know. Bzzz. Anyway, I'm going to turn the camera off, because this is probably just about to end. How long have we got? 6 minutes. So in 6 minutes, I'm going to be soaking in a nice hot bath and scratching the shit out of my legs, probably. Well, I'm back here at the battery. We'll see if it's had any joy. Let's flip that round to the 20 volt range. Is there any way I can just... Is that going to stay in there? No, it isn't, is it? It's going to be a pain. Tell you what. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm bloody doing here. Put you there. And grab me pokey sticks. What are we reading? 7.18 volts. I did that earlier and then went back down again. So I'm going to test it before I go to bed again, because it seems, it almost seems like it hits the 7-volt area and then starts to drop again, because I dropped down to 6.9 something earlier. I only dropped a little. We'll see. Hoping I can get some charge in it. Right. It's 10 past midnight. Town's gone quiet. I'm guessing England lost against Russia, and I've been seeing in the news that there's been a lot of violence. I don't know if the media is being truthful, you know. You just don't know whether to trust the media or not, but they, from the way they write it, it sounds like the Russians instigated it. I don't know, though. Of course, I'm not going to judge Russia by what a handful of football hooligans are doing. Someone actually said on a radio interview earlier when I had the radio on, you know, you can't tar all the football supporters with the same brush, because when you look at the number causing trouble compared to the actual number of supporters there, it's pretty small. The number causing trouble, I mean, is pretty small. And I thought, yeah, he's got a good point there. Well, I think it's easy to, what's the word? Get caught up with something, you know, in temper. You see it, it pisses you off. Bloody blah blah. Take these to the bedroom. Ouch. Nemo's sitting up here on the window ledge. Right. Oh, some proper clips for that. Kick that under the bed. Oh, yeah. The moth flying around in here. I forgot I had the camera pointed at me. I thought it was still pointing the other way. That's actually got going in there. In the lounge. Go over there. Oh, why is my nose running? Oh! Still on something shit up. Ah. I'll need that screw. Turn the meter off, didn't I? Yep. I think before I settle, because it'll probably be a couple of hours before I settle and go to bed, I'll give it one more check. But I've just basically been sitting around doing bugger all evening. I've had quite a chilling evening. I did do a little modification to this. Moved the door and took a window out and just put the one window there. And I did that just so as I could get that Lego bed in there without it blocking any of the door, because the way I positioned all the doors was a bit stupid, really. Well, I didn't have a lot of choice for that one or that one. I couldn't, can't really move those, can I? There we go. So, oh, I won both lamps. Oh, what if he sent me an invoice? I'm hoping he does combined shipping.
I hope. If not, oh well. Shit, I just clicked on the wrong one. I'm nuts. He has...
Yep, he has given a postage discount. It was £4.85 postage. He's charging me £5.95 for both, that's fine. I think he's not... Was it £4.95, something like that. He's knocked a couple of quid off anyway. So, £19.93. So, if I keep a £20 note aside, I could stick that in. That'll make life easier. So, once I pay for him, he did relist this one. That ends next weekend, so I need to raise about another 20 quid to get that. Then I'll probably find some other asshole who will decide to bid on it as well. I think I've got enough of them. Well, that reminds me, I want to raise a bit of cash as well to get the other one of them, the static one. Not the bloody flash one. I still can't believe I did that, dipstick. I was sure I clicked buy it now on one of the static ones he had for sale, but obviously I didn't. Because even when I checked eBay, it says I'd bought the flashy one, so... Bullocks. What I say to that. Oh dear. So I've now got two flashing ones with a photo cell. And technically two flashy ones without. But I don't have any static ones, so I really do want to get one of the static ones. I don't know, I could probably sell one of the other ones on. Probably make a bit of a loss, but eh. Who cares? Could try even car booting one for a few quid. I have seen them at car boots. You'd be surprised at what you find at car boot sales. That's why I love going to them. But you just got to have the cash and the transport. And I have neither. Well, I could get on a train on a Tuesday and go to Cromer's. And I could take the Black Claude Butler with the saddlebag, so I've got something to put everything in. That reminds me, I need to put a bungee cord in one of them saddlebags. Just because I find by the time I put like a pack of cat food and a Coke bottle in it, it's full. I can't get no other large items in the bags. So I figured if I carry a bungee strap, I could strap things down to the top. Because a couple of Coke bottles will strap down on there nicely. The pack of cat food would strap on there nicely. And that leaves the bags free for smaller bits and bobs. Ow. Right. Pick these two screws up as I keep standing on them and put them in the battery pack because they're for the contacts on the end there to screw that back down. If I remember, I'll do Nemo's tray before I go tomorrow. Because that needs doing. Surprised he hasn't crazed my arse for me to do it yet. He normally does. When it starts getting a bit melly. Right, so yeah. The only thing I'm doing tomorrow is going to Mum's. And going to the dump. Seeing what I can find out. My nose really is running tonight. I know I've just eaten. I cooked up some crinkle cut chips in the oven. I don't use fried. I used to do fried, but... Nah. That Permic lamp, he's put that back up as well. So if I could actually raise enough, I could get that one. Because that's got a different reflector to my Permic lamp. that actually looks like an actual reflector, not reflective tape, you know, an actual plastic reflector. Because I've got that Permic one right up the end there. There's another one on eBay with a plastic handle strap on it, but he's asking far too much for that. Well, to me, he's asking too much for it. I think it was something like 20 quid or something like that. I mean, originally I bought four of those Permic ones, but I think I put three back on eBay. Should have kept another one, really. I'll find another one on eBay. I may get one, because I do like having things in pairs. I don't know why, I just don't like odd numbers. My mum's just the same. So I don't think it's an autistic thing necessarily, but my mum, my sister is the same as well. If she's playing games or something, she's got to finish on an even number. And like I said, I like to have even numbers of things. It doesn't always work like that, but that's what I prefer. I mean, I've got four of those. That was unintentional. Well, it was intentional, but the types I've got were unintentional. Because of numbnuts here. Right, never mind. Shit happens. But, yeah. There's my doorman. That one's a little bit battered. It's definitely, corners are a bit bent. What do you expect when it's been used, you know? It's been thrown around in vans and trucks and... I don't know, I can't even remember where the... Oh yeah, I bought this one from a car boot sale. Cost me £2. I just couldn't resist it for that price. So you're probably wondering, why would I pay £8 if I paid £2 for it, or even £10? Because the painted up one was a tenner alone. Still smells of paint. Fresh paint. So I don't think it's actually been long since it... Or I don't think it was that long ago that that was painted. Well, I get my teeth in and get my words out. That one's actually in pretty good condition. It's a shame it hasn't got the doorman stickers on it. This one's got Batchley. Unless Batchley is a company and doorman made it for them. But I always thought Batchley was the distributor. Because I've got two in the bedroom. One really, really, really old one. And my JSP Plastiflash. Both have... well... Plastiflash here, that's got Batchley on this side, and if I turn or look at the bottom printing, it's got JSP Plastiflash on it. So it's definitely, and that's a visibility, so yes, Batchley is definitely the distributor. See, that one's got Greenham on it, because that was another distributor. I've actually seen some JSP Maxi lights on eBay with a Greenham sticker on as well. I've got a couple of specialist ones. I've got one US one over there. That one. That one right there, the red one. That's actually an American one. But I can't remember who made it. Hang on. Doesn't say on it. Is that a Dietz? Is it a Dietz? No, it's an Empco. Empco light. And it works. And if I remember rightly, I think that's got a choice of static and flash. When you hit the button. That was actually from the same seller I've just bought these two lamps from. Betty Swaddocks. Not a big eBayer in the sense that they don't list lots of items and they don't list that regularly, but every now and again they Betty Swaddocks list lamps like that, X road signs from the police force and whatnot. Just, I don't know where he gets all the gear from, but he just lists X equipment like that. Oh, pardon me.
Yeah.
Right. As much as I'd like to stand and chatter, as I love to, I'll switch his camera off. Not much more I can do to me house, apart from get all the garden done. I want a garden pond in this, but I don't think I've got room. Not for what I want to do anyway. I could put a little one up this corner, I suppose. Some trees and flowers and... I don't think I've got enough tiles to tile in a driveway yet. Let's see. That's the weird part about my town. This part of the house is going to be facing the street. Same as that one, you see. But I have seen such a layout done in real life. Well, my building here doesn't face a road at all. The front doesn't anyway, neither does the back. The ends do. Right. Ooh, la la. Right. This is an LED flashing road warning hazard lamp. Yes, I've got one of those. Handy stuff. It's not that expensive either. A lock nut. BMX lock nut. Yes, and what? These are all from the same seller. 2006 Jar 89. Yeah, 2006 Jar 89. He's always got lamps up. He's been trying to sell some of his lamps for months. But he hasn't got anything that's I haven't already got, so. Scroll down, see if I can quickly see anything of interest in the list of people I follow. Probably not. Some laptops. Blah 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 blah. It's all stuff that's been put up recently. Ooh, Ferrari. London bus, another laptop. Lego, fire extinguishers, bike, Homer and Bart Simpson. Lamps! Those are the ones I wanted. Dickhead here clicked on the wrong one and thus received the wrong one. I can't blame the seller for that, can I? It's my own stupid fault. Well, I'm gonna keep it. Just because I can. See, you put a sticker back on that. What does this one do? I can't remember. I think he's listed it as new. Da-da-da. He's asking £14 for it, but free postage. Metal body static photo cell, which means it will work when it gets dark enough. Small paint chip at the side. You know, I actually think... I don't think that one's actually been repainted. I think that is a new one. Right, well, I'm going to fuck off for the night, so... Thanks for watching. Oh, look, an old fire engine. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you all tomorrow. Adios, amigos.